rise for the entry of the official party. Honors to General Mattis, and remain standing for the presentation of the colors.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Armada of the Marine Corps, Lieutenant General John A. Leisure, directed that a reminder of the honorable service of the Corps be published by every command to all Marines throughout the globe on the birthday of the Corps. Since that date, Marines have continued to distinguish themselves on many battlefields and foreign shores, in war and peace. On this birthday of the Corps, therefore, in recognition of the will of the 13th Commandant, a reminder of the Corps' honorable service is republished as follows. The timeless and inspiring message of our 13th Commandant has left its mark in the hearts and minds of all Marines past and present. By deed and act, from Belle Wood to the Argonne, from Guadalcanal to Iwo Jima, from Incheon to the Korean Armistice, from the hard fights in Vietnam to Desert Shield, Desert Storm, to this century's longest wars in Iraq and Afghanistan, and in hundreds of other places where Marines have distinguished themselves, Marines have continued to epitomize those qualities which serve as our legacy. The success which the men and women who have earned the title Marine have achieved in combat, and the faith they have borne in peace will endure forever. The Commandant and our many friends have added their hearty praise and congratulations on this, our 247th birthday. Cake cutting ceremony is important to all Marines as it is an annual renewal of each Marine's commitment to the Corps and the Corps' commitment to our nation's quest for peace and freedom worldwide. The birthday cake is traditionally cut with the Mameluke sword as a reminder that we are a committed to carrying the sword so that our nation may live in peace. As is our custom, the first piece of kit will be presented to tonight's guest of honor, General Mattis. Tradition, the next piece of cake is presented to the oldest Marine in attendance as a sign of honor and respect according to experience and seniority. This evening, our oldest Marine is Major Billy Hull, USMC retired. He enlisted in the Marine Corps in August of 1941, and during his years of service, he saw action on Guadalcanal, Peleliu, and in Korea. A native of Hereford, Texas, Major Hull was born on 11 March 1926. For 247 years, our experienced Marines have nurtured and led young Marines to fill our ranks and renew our Corps. The oldest Marine passes the piece of cake to the youngest Marine, symbolizing the passing of wisdom, knowledge, and experience, as well as trust and confidence in those who will carry on our Marine Corps tradition into the future. This evening, our youngest Marine is Lance Cpl. A native of Bensonville, Illinois, Lance Cpl. Gomez Robles was born on 11 November, 2004. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the retirement of the colors and the departure of the official party. Australia, where the division maintained a training base in World War II and prepared for the island campaign. Over the next Over the decades, the division's Marines and sailors have marched off to war to this historic tomb. We ask that those who served in the division from World War II to those currently serving with the Blue Diamond today stand to be recognized. We respectfully request all others remain seated and silent to honor those absent who gave the ultimate sacrifice and those present who have served the 1st Marine Division. After the playing of Waltzing Matilda, we ask all others to please rise for the playing of Anchor's Way and the Marines' Hymn. It is now customary that Marines present and who have served honorably sing the first verse of the hymn.